Joining us now, the head coach of the Grandview Vikings, Mike Woodley, prior to the contest as we begin conference play Saturday in Deerfield, Illinois against Trinity International. And Mike, before we get to the game on hand, reflecting back on the game at Drake, frankly, a frustrating game, I'm sure, for the players and coaches, losing in overtime 28-21.
Yeah, it was. Geoff, it was very disappointing. We had a chance to win the game, and we didn't get it done. We didn't make enough plays when we needed to make them. It wasn't the overtime. It wasn't the last drive of the game, that beat us. It was throughout the game. We shot ourselves in the foot way too many times with turnovers and lost opportunities. We're on the goal line stand that Drake had, the blocked field goal where it was a fundamental breakdown in our protection. Just things like that. We did it to ourselves, and we got nobody to blame. Just look in the mirror and say, we didn't help ourselves.
There's no question that Grandview competed right from the get-go. I mean, Drake drove down the field opening drive of the game, took the 7-0 lead, but Grandview responds, took a 14-7 lead, and then a lead 21-14 on Darren Davis's spectacular catch. How about a word on Darren's play on Saturday?
Well, Darren, he probably had his best game, as a Viking, in my opinion, both not just catching the ball, but, his all-around game was really good. And it was nice to see that, the long touchdown run that he had where he broke two tackles over there on the sideline right in front of our bench was a great play. And then he made a great adjustment on his touchdown there at the end to put us up 21-14. I thought he had a really, really good game.
And Greg Charles, aside from getting a little banged up in the final 5 minutes where he had to sit and Colt Matthews came in, Greg was very serviceable, 10 of 19, 218. Three touchdowns rather, and no picks. He was very good, very solid on Saturday.
Yeah, he was. And that's what we expect out of Greg. Looking back at the week before where he made a few mistakes, he played like a senior quarterback Saturday. He moved our football team, made the plays that he needed to make, and I was real proud of his effort bouncing back from the Marion game and taking the bull by the horn and just saying, hey, I'm going to lead this team. And then he did a very, very good job until he got hurt.
Again, Grandview head football coach Mike Woodley here on our weekly talk with the head coach. As far as offensively, finishing with 366 yards of total offense, 218 to 148 on the ground, kind of evaluate your offense.
Well, we were really good out there between the 20s, Geoff. And, the big disappointment, obviously, was the goal line stand. And, hindsight's always 20-20, and maybe we should have run some different plays. Obviously, maybe we should have. And we'll always second-guess ourselves on that, and that's what we do as coaches, to put our kids in a position to be successful. And maybe we didn't on that. I don't know. But we just got to build on that, because the offense moved the ball well enough most of the day. We had a couple turnovers. One was critical. But for the most part, they did a pretty good job today. But it is. It's disheartening when we're down inside the 10 twice and we come away with no points. And we've got to get that corrected. That's unacceptable to get down there and not come away with some points.
Now, defensively, Coach, rushing defense was incredible. The Bulldogs managing just 31 yards on the ground, 313 through the air, and Piakowski was a tough guy to defend.
Yeah, well, we knew that going in, Geoff. We knew, he's an excellent quarterback, he played well. I mean, he made play after play, and on that tying touchdown, when you look at it on tape, we had three guys right there, and he threw it in a window of about 2 feet by 2 feet. To get that touchdown scored on the last play of regulation. But, that's hats off to him. He made a play when they needed it. And the disappointing part of that passing yardage was we made a few mistakes here and there, or we lost contain on the quarterback and bought him some time. Then the one that really hurt was when we took the 14-7 lead and they throw a bomb. And we're in the perfect coverage to be in, we're down there. We got a mental error, and they tied it up right after we took the lead and kind of took our momentum and took the steam out of us a little bit. which we kind of did to ourselves all day long. You know, you take that play, you take the goal line stand, you take the field goal. I mean, those momentum swings and then the changes there, sometimes those are, you know, hard to overcome, which, you know, that's kind of how the game ended too. You know, they scored on the last play, then they came out in the overtime and it only took them about three plays to score. So they won the momentum battle there going back into the overtime. And that's kind of what the game was like all day long, it seemed like.
All right, Coach, let's move now to the game Saturday against Trinity International. This is where the real season begins, the conference season. Grandview's march to claim a automatic bid, hopefully, to the playoffs for the first time by winning the league, and it all starts on Saturday with Trinity International. They're coming off a win over Concordia, Michigan, 13-10, even up their season at 1-1. What can you give us a general idea about the Trojans?
Well, you know, like we told the kids, you know, even after the game, you know, our preseason's over. You know, even though Marion's in our league, they're on the other side, and it doesn't count, you know, in our conference standings for our side. But, you know, we think we played a tough preseason schedule, and now it's time to, you know, cinch our hats up and let's go to work and let's take this one at a time and win these conference games. And our first obstacle is Trinity International, who is coming off a win last week over Concordia. They're a vastly improved football team from where they were a year ago, and they're a well-coached group by watching the tape. So we're going to have our hands full, plus it's a road game, and you know, well, we got to rebound because these conference games are what count right now. And that's, you know, our ultimate goal this year is to make the playoffs, which you got to win the conference to do that. And this is the first game in that sequence of where we're headed.
Now, does this Trinity team, do they like to run the ball more, pass the ball more, kind of even up? What's the go there?
Well, they've got a, you know, they've got a really good receiver, and you know, he caught a couple touchdown passes last week, made some big plays for him. So they're kind of a mixture. Just watching them on tape, run and pass both. They're not one dimensional by any means. So we're going to have to stop the run. And hopefully, if they're throwing the football, we'll be better defending it this week than we were this last weekend. Because we always want to make them, you know, a one-dimensional team, and we always want to stop the run. And hopefully, we can accomplish that. And you know, that's going to be the key to the game. You know, we got to take care of the run and make them be one-dimensional.
Again, Granby stands 1-2 after the non-conference season, heading into Saturday's game with Trinity International. They're also coming off a their one loss was to St. Ambrose, a team that Grammy will see later in the season, 44-9 in their opener. Their running back, they had a freshman running back by the name of Namu Keys with 116 yards rushing. So it's one of a couple of guys that they feature in the backfield.
Well, it's like I said earlier, they, you know, they're gonna run in, throw the football. You know, they got the good receiver and they got the good running back, and you know, we're going to have to, you know, we're going to have a good defensive effort, as we always do. And, you know, to key on somebody, we don't exactly key on anybody or double team people and all that. We just got to play good, sound team defense, and hopefully that'll be enough to shut down their offense.
Let me ask you about the mindset of the team. We're recording this earlier in the week, but coming off a couple of frustrating losses to Marion and Drake back to back, how do you feel that the mindset of the team is ready to go into the conference run?
Well, we've got a veteran team, Geoff. So, you know, if we were young and fragile, and I'd be a little more concerned. But we got a bunch of seniors, and they know what it takes to get it done. And I think they've shown that in the past. You know, the last 2 years, we've played well in conference games. And they understand what's at stake, and you know, they're going to step up. I don't think we'll have any issues there as far as getting them ready to play a conference game.
Any idea on the injury front? Any players banged up? I know Greg left the last few moments of the Drake game, and I think Jared Scruggs maybe twisted an ankle.
Well, I wish that's all Jared Scruggs would have done. You know, our trainer Luke Steele thinks that the Jared's injury is a little more severe. It might be a patellar tendon that's torn, and he'd be lost for the season. That would be a big loss for us. And then Gavin Burns separated his shoulder and has a concussion, so he's definitely out this week. And hopefully in maybe 2 weeks, maybe we'll get Gavin back. But at this point, we don't know yet. But his range of motion was pretty good with his shoulder. And, you know, our trainer feels pretty good that, you know, he should be able to go here in another week or two.
And you had to bring in Colt Matthews at the end of the direct game, just getting back to that. Obviously, Colt had the fumble that ended the game, but it's a tough situation to come into.
Yeah, it was tough, but we expect our, you know, our backup quarterback to come in and execute. You know, he doesn't get the reps that Greg gets, but I thought he did a really good job. I was real proud of Colt coming in under those circumstances and getting one big first down for us. Thought he did a nice job. So, but with Greg's situation, you know, he hurt his knee earlier in the year, and he's kind of been hampered with that knee. And then in addition to that, he got cramps there at the end of the game, and you know, his legs were all knotted up, and you know, that's a painful thing, and he just couldn't go again. And you know, that's just the way it is sometimes. You know, went into the overtime and basically the end of the game, you know, without our starting quarterback.
And the trip to Deerfield, Illinois, the second overnight trip, one of the second of two overnight trips for the team this year. Of course, the one at Black Hill State a few weeks back. But give us an idea of the travel plans for this trip.
Well, we'll probably leave, you know, right after lunch on Friday, Geoff, and head over to Deerfield, and then we'll try to get a little walkthrough over at their field on Friday night, and then obviously get out and play the game on, you know, on Saturday. So. You know, we'll have the kids will be focused. I mean, they generally are when we go on the road. We've been a good road team, and hopefully that stays the same. Stay focused.
All right, Coach. Thanks. We'll see you Saturday.
Thanks, Geoff.
Head Coach Mike Woodley.
Comes back.